Hey guys, real quick video. Just trying to get rid of a tiny squeak that I mentioned in my last video. It's so small, it's barely worth worrying about, but I'm going to go ahead and try it to do this. I'm going to, I think these pads will probably come out just with these pins. I'm going to see how this works. You may not have to take off the whole caliper with a 21 inch here. So let me look at the pins first on these sweet Brembo brakes. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and pop out these brakes with a little simple punch. Pop out my pins. In the bottom. I can probably pull them out by hand here. See, I'm going to press down this bracket so there's no pressure on it. Pull out the bracket, then gently let this go so it doesn't snap. Then, of course, it's easier to get it out like that. This is the same. Check it everywhere. Doesn't go matter which way it goes, so you know that that's going back in like that. Finish your pins out. Now you got full access to your brake pads. How these pins stay in here, you have a little elongated piece here, which is the tension point. So it's not too stiff all the way in here, same length, but you have this extra little piece which compresses, and that's where it locks in place in the back. Right where you tap in the last bit, that's what locks it solid. Then these pads should come right out. You can again take one of your punches, very gently pry it. You don't want to scratch up your nice calipers or anything. Like that. And the other one should come out easier because there's less pressure now. Like that. So I'm going to mark, I'm going to keep them. The inside is on the inside of my blanket, and the outer one is in the outer of my blanket. Make sure I don't get these mixed up. On the stock pads, you can see the copper anti-seize under this plate. This one is probably okay. I'm not sure if I want to change it, but I might since it's out anyway. Just to be sure, I got the disc brake quiet spray, which is really good. I may pull these shims off and replace this stuff, which, I mean, it's probably pretty good. It's factory, but I know this stuff is good. I've used it for a long time. Extra sticky, stops vibrations. So I don't want to take this apart twice. I'm probably going to take these shims right off. Just unclip them and do a dual-sided here. It's easier than it looks. You pull on the single tab side, not the duals. Duals hook around the bottom. So you lift up, slide it out. That's it. On this one, I'm going to clean all the mating surfaces and do some spraying. So I started out by spraying the backside of these stock shims, which are going to be placed over these brake pads. Just need one side. You don't need both sides here. Since the only place you need it is where it makes contact, which is on those round piston markings, you can do a little cleaner job if you just tape up the excess. Then you don't spray your whole pad for nothing. This stuff is sticky and it'll attract a lot of dust and dirt, so better not to overdo it. Let it set up for maybe a couple minutes, a little bit. Peel off your excess. Then you have a nice, sticky, thick pad surface there to absorb the vibrations which are causing the squeak. The minute vibrations under light braking usually. Heavy, you're pushing so hard it stops it. But under those slow stops you do around town all day long, that's when the squeaks come up. Nice clean setup. I'm going to put this pad on the inside, drop it in, then wiggle the other one to the outside. This outer one might be a bit tighter. Just to wiggle your rotor a bit, figure it out. Got it. Take a rubber mallet. I was about to just do a shortcut and use my metal hammer, but it's best not to take shortcuts and just get the right parts. Do it right. Take your time. Nothing should be rushed on this. Just gently tap it in. Get the holes lined up. It's about right. Pads are back in. So you put in your top pin a little bit, slide your squeak adapter, whatever it is, brake hardware as I call it, and then you push it down to get your other pin under there like that, and you just work it until your pins come all the way through. Then I'm going to gently tap them in from the inside here, keeping it just like it was factory, just in case there's a difference in hole size. I don't know, but it's not something you want to risk. I'll just tap these in till they're flush, then this should be done. These will bottom out and stop when you got them in far enough, so don't stop. I'll do like a little side tap with a punch. Bottomed out. And done. To finish the seat, I just step on the brake pedal for 1 second just to make sure the pistons are nice and tight. I'm not going to drive it for a little while. Let that red goop set up real nice and sticky and get in place. I'll drive it later, see how it sounds. And as a quick side note, anybody wondering where they put the jack? There's a square cutout right toward the front of there. It has a piece of metal right underneath this thing. It's not the molding. This is actual metal. So the jack fits perfectly in there, jacks it right up.